Hi folks, Lance from Runtime Recruitment. Hope you're having a great time wherever you are. Look, I know we're living in some very strange times. I operate a lot in Australia, and I know that a lot of companies are struggling at the moment to cope with the pandemic. There is a lot of uncertainty in the market at the moment, but companies are still operating and work is still continuing. And now we are coming out of the lockdown. Work will start to get back to some sort of normality. We don't know exactly what that's going to look like. So anyway, I wanted to just put this out there, guys. I know this is really something that you guys in the embedded world, particularly ones who are writing firmware, are working with, the tool chains, right? So we're going to talk a little bit about the tool chains today. And I want you guys to give me your input. Tell me what kind of tool chains you're using. There's a lot of chip vendors that are actually providing tool chains like STM and also SEGGAR. A lot of companies have bought tool chain companies and integrated their tool chains into their chip offerings as a bundle. So lots of choice. There's also obviously open source GCC for embedded systems development as well. I just want you guys to sort of tell me what your thoughts are. SEGGAR is one of the companies that I have a tool chain for. It's a IDE in integrated development environment. It has your debuggers and compilers and linkers, and it also downloads to the target, and you can debug on the target using JTAG technology. So SEGGAR obviously is a great company. They provide also graphics libraries and a number of other tools. A company called IAR Systems, they've been around a long, long time. Even back in the day, they've been making compilers for embedded systems for a long time for microcontrollers, and they offer a very good tool chain as well. Now, you have a choice. You can run your tool chain on Windows or on Linux. As you can see here, it's running. This is Eclipse, obviously, which is the open source IDE. A lot of people are using Eclipse on a Linux environment. Not sure if you guys are. If you are, why don't you do me a favor? Put a screenshot if you want to blur some of the content. Great, but put a screenshot in your comments so that we can have a look at what tools you're using. This is by no means a comprehensive collection of tools. There are so many more out there. I'd like you to share your thoughts and let me know what tool chains you're using. This one's on Mac. Some people are using Mac as well as their base workstation, if you like, for development. This is all I wanted to say, was just to find out a little bit more what you guys are doing. Look, the thing is, you guys are developing real systems out there. This is obviously aimed at the firmware engineers, but a lot of you are also hardware and software and firmware engineers. You're doing a hybrid of different activities. You're using these types of tools as well as the PCB layout and circuit design tools and debugging tools as well. Or it could be even Arduino. Some people might be even using the Arduino interface to build commercial products. Be great to hear your thoughts. Please leave your comments. Let me know what your thoughts are on IDEs in general. What do you think about IDEs? Are they useful? And also, what about IDEs for embedded Linux? Are you guys using IDEs for embedded Linux and debugging? Let me know what your thoughts are, and I'll see you in the next one. And keep the faith. It's all going to be good in the long run. I hope you guys are well and healthy, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.